Hi everyone. Today we can discuss exercise 22B, question number 9 onwards. A man on a cliff observes a boat at an angle of depression 30 degree which is sailing towards the shore to the point immediately beneath him. 3 minutes later, the angle of depression of the boat is found to be 60 degree. Assuming that the boat sails at a uniform speed, determine first one, how much more time it will take to reach the shore. That is, we have to find out the time taken from B to C. We have to find out. That is our first question. Then second one is, the speed of the boat in meter per second, if the height of the cliff is 500 meter. So height of the cliff is given as 500 meter. So given, a man on a cliff observes a boat at an angle of depression 30 degree. So this we can mark it as 30 degree. And later, 3 minutes later, next sentence is what? 3 minutes later, the angle of depression of the boat is found to be 60 degree. So after 3 minutes, the angle of depression become 60 degree. So angle of depression is 30 degree means what will be this angle? This angle will also be 30 degree since these two are parallel. This one is the transversal. So alternate angle concept we can apply here also. So here this is 60 degree, so this also will be 60 degree, alternate angles concept. 60 degrees, height is given as 500. So if we consider triangle DBC, if we consider triangle DBC, tan 60 degree will be what? Tan is equal to opposite divided by tan 60, opposite divided by adjacent. So what will be tan 60 opposite divided by adjacent? That is 500 divided by adjacent is BC, tan 60. So tan 60 value root 3 is equal to 500 divided by BC. Therefore, BC is equal to, that is root 3 BC is equal to 500. Therefore, we can write BC is equal to 500 divided by root 3. Okay, then next we can take tan 30. Tan 30 is equal to what? Same way, tan 30 is equal to, if we consider triangle, which one? If we consider triangle DAC, that big triangle DAC, tan 30 is equal to opposite divided by adjacent. So opposite is what? DC. So we can write it as 500 divided by AC. What about the tan 30 value? Tan 30 is 1 by root 3 is equal to 500 divided by AC. Cross multiply AC into 1. AC is equal to 500 root 3. So AC is 500 root 3 and BC is what? 500 by root 3. So this will be, this is what? 500 divided by root 3 and this is 500 root 3. So what about AB? AB will be, therefore AB is equal to what? AC minus BC. AC is 500 root 3 minus 500 divided by root 3. That is the value of AB. That is the length AB. Okay. So LCM what? Root 3. So 500 root 3 into root 3. We can write it as 3 minus 500 into 1. 500 divided by 1 into root 3 is root 3. So 5 3s are 15. Then 2 zeros minus 500 divided by root 3, so which is equal to 1000 divided by root 3. AB we got it as 1000 divided by root 3. BC. BC means the distance between B and C, no? Same way AB is what, the distance between A and B. We have to find out, first we can find the time taken from A to B. How can we find that? It is given as after 3 minutes. No, so time taken is given as 3 minutes. So time taken from, given time taken from A to B is what? From A to B, after 3 minutes, the angle of depression changes from 30 degree to 60 degree is given. So time taken from A to B is given as 3 minutes in the question. So 3 minutes we can convert it into seconds. So how can we write? 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 3 minutes is equal to 3 into 60 seconds. So which is equal to 180 seconds. Time taken from A to B, we got it as 180 seconds. Then, what about the distance between A and B? Distance between A and B is 1000 divided by root 3. So, distance we have, AB is what? This is known as the distance, no? Distance between A and B, that is AB. So, distance is, we got is 1000 divided by root 3. Time also we have from A to B is 180 seconds. So, how can we find speed? Speed is equal to, formula for finding speed is equal to distance divided by time, no? So, speed formula write down. Distance between A and B is 1000 divided by root 3. So, to calculate speed, speed is equal to distance divided by time taken. So, distance is what? 1000 divided by root 3, then divided by, instead of that by a root division symbol, time taken as 180 seconds. So how can we calculate that? 1000 divided by root 3 into 1 by 180. So 0, 0 we can cancel. Then cancellation, which one is possible here? 50, here it will be, but 27, is it possible? So I am not writing directly that 27, so 2 times cancel, 100 cancel, write it as 50 and 18 cancel. So we got it as 50 divided by 9 root 3, root 3. So we can rationalize that, we can multiply by 1 root 3. So it will be 50 root 3 divided by 9 into root 3, 3. So 50 root 3 divided by 27. So let it be there, 50 root 3 divided by 27. Then we can convert that root 3 in decimals. So how can we convert that? Root 3 value is 1.732. So substitute, which is equal to 50 into 1.732 divided by 27. So after multiplication, then divide by 27, you will get it as 3.207 meter per second. That we can write it as 3.2 meter per second. So the speed, we got it as 3.2 meter per second. Then next we have to find out the time taken from B to C. So from this formula, how can we find time taken? Time taken means, formula is what? Time taken is equal to what? Distance divided by speed. Distance divided by speed. So, time taken from B to C. So, that same time taken from B to C, we have to find out. So, we have to take the distance from here also B to C. So, what will be the distance from B to C? we know the distance from B to C is what we have already 500 divided by root 3. Then our question is what? It's a uniform speed. Uniform speed is given. So what will be the speed? Now we got the speed as 3.2 meter per second. So this speed we can write it as 3.2. So uniform speed means speed will be same, 3.2. So here root 3 is there in the numerator. So instead of writing this, how we got this 3.2? By substituting root 3 value as 1.732, and after calculation we got it as 3.2. So instead of writing this 3.2, since numerator we have root 3, for our convenience speed we can write this one, that is 50 root 3 divided by 27. So instead of this 3.2, the decimal form, we will write this 50 root 3 divided by 27. So how can we write this? 500 root 3 divided by, so this is the distance from B to C, that is 500 divided by root 3. Speed is uniform, so 550 root 3 divided by 27. So we can write this divided by, instead of this division, I wrote it as division symbol. So 50 root 3 divided by 27, then reciprocal. So taking reciprocal, 500 divided by root 3 into 27 divided by 50 root 3. So root 3 into root 3 we can write it as 500 into 27 numerator divided by 50 into this we can write it as root 3 into root 3 is what? 3. Okay, 3 and 9 3s are 27, this 0 0 we can cancel, 10. So numerator 10 into 9 we got, that is equal to 90 seconds. We want to write that seconds because we convert that into seconds. No, so we got the answer in 90 seconds. So how can we write in minutes? 90 seconds. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Seconds. That is 60 minutes. Either we can say for 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. What about 1 second? 1 second is equal to 1 divided by 60 minute. We need 90 seconds. So 90 seconds is equal to 90 divided by 60 minute. So this we can write it as 90 divided by 60 minutes. Okay. So cancel 9 divided by 6. You can write in decimals. It will be 1.5 minutes. Okay. The next question. Next question number 10. A man in a boat rowing away from a lighthouse 150 meter high takes 2 minutes to change the angle of elevation of the top of the lighthouse from 60 degree to 45 degree. Find the speed of the boat. Then height of the lighthouse is given as 150 meter. Takes 2 minutes to change the angle of elevation of the top of the lighthouse from 60 degree to 45 degree. So from 60 degree to 45 degree takes time 2 minutes. So time taken from C to D is 60 degree to 45 minutes, means time taken from C to D is what? Given time taken from C to D is given as 2 minutes. It is there in the question, 2 minutes. That is, we can write it as 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 2 minutes is equal to 2 into 60, that is 120 seconds. 120 seconds. Then next, we have to find out the speed of the boat. Speed of the boat means, how can we find that speed of the boat? So for that, first we can consider same as usual way. Consider triangle ACB and triangle AD. DB, big triangle and a small triangle. So tan 60, if we consider triangle, ACB, what about tan 60? Tan 60 is equal to opposite. Opposite means 150 divided by BC, adjacent BC. So tan 60 is root 3 is equal to 150 divided by BC. So root 3 BC is equal to 150. So BC will be what? 150 divided by root 3. Similarly, if we consider triangle ADB, there also tan 45 is equal to opposite is what? 150 divided by adjacent DB. Tan 45 1 is equal to 150 divided by DB. That means DB is equal to 150. So DB is 150 and BC is what? 150 divided by root 3. Okay. We have to find out the speed of the boat. That means speed of the boat means speed between this one D and C. No, these are the two boats. So speed we have to find out. This speed we want to find out. For finding speed, we need the distance between D and C, and time taken is what? We got time as what? 120. C to D we have 120 seconds. Time we have, but we have to find out which one. Distance we have to find out. Then only we can find speed. How can we find the distance between C and D? Already we have BC is equal to and what? DB. So what will be the distance? Total distance is 150. From B and B to C is 150 divided by root 3. So what will be DC? DC will be DB minus CB. That is 150 divided by 150 by root 3. Okay. So taking LCM, 150 can be written as 150 by 1. So DC is equal to 150 into root 3 is 150 root 3 minus 150 into 1, 150 divided by 1 into root 3, root 3. Okay. So from here, numerator 150 root 3 minus 150. Both have 150. So we can take 150 common. Then balance will be root 3 minus, already we took 150, so balance 1 only will be there, divided by root 3. Okay, so distance between C and D we got it as 150 into root 3 minus 1 divided by root 3. So let it be there. That means the distance between D and C we have, and the time taken from C to D we have. We have to find out the speed. Speed is equal to speed between two boats. No, speed of the boats we have to find out. That will be our final answer. So speed is equal to what? Formula for finding speed is what? Distance divided by time taken. Time taken. So what is the distance? Now we got it as 150 into root 3 minus 1 divided by root 3 is the distance, this one, divided by time taken is 120 seconds. Okay. So how can we do this calculation? It is equal to 150 into root 3 minus 1 divided by root 3 into 1 by 120. So which is equal to root 3 denominator, so we have to rationalize that into 1 by 20 into root 3 divided by root 3. So it will be 150 into root 3 minus 1 into root 3 will be there. Then root 3 into root 3, 3 into 120. Then 0, 0 we can cancel. Here 3 is table. 4 3s are 12, 5 3s are 15. Okay, so numerator we will get 5 into root 3 minus 1 into root 3 divided by 3 into 4. So final answer you will get it as substituting root 3 as 1.732 minus 1. Then into again root 3 value you have to substitute 1.732. Then you will get the final answer as 0.528 meter per second. Okay. In question number 11. A person standing on the bank of a river observes that the angle of elevation of the top of a tree standing in the opposite bank is 60 degrees. When he moves 40 meters away from the bank, he finds the angle of elevation to be 30 degrees. Find the height of the tree, correct it to 2 decimal places. Then second one, width of the river. So, what is given? A person standing on the bank of a river observes that the angle of elevation of the top of the tree standing on the opposite bank is 60 degrees. So let B, C the width of the, this will be the width of the river. Width of the river. And A, B is the height. So if he observes from the top of the tree, angle of depression is 60 degrees. So we can write this angle C as what? 60 degree. And after some time what they are saying, angle of elevation of the top of the tree standing on the opposite bank is 60 degree is given as 60 degree. Then when he moves away from the bank, when he moves away from the bag means 40 meter away, he finds the angle of elevation changes to 30 degree. So that means angle of depression changes to 30 degree means, so we can write angle of elevation as 30 degree. We have to find out the height of the tree corrected to 2 decimal places. No? Then same concept we can apply here. What are the things we have to find out here? We have to find the width of the river, we have to find out. Then height of the tree also we have to find out. Width of the river means BC we can find first. So from there we will get what height of the tree. So first consider triangle ACB. If we consider triangle, ACB. Tan 60 degrees is equal to AB divided by BC. Tan 60 is equal to AB divided by BC. We don't know AB and BC, we don't know. So cross multiply tan 60 value we can substitute. Root 3 is equal to AB divided by BC. Therefore we can write AB is equal to root 3 BC. That means AB is the height, you know. So height is equal to root 3 times BC. So let it be this. We don't have the values AB and BC. Then next you consider triangle ADB. Consider triangle ADB. So here also tan 30 degrees is equal to AB divided by DB. So how can we write 1 divided by root 3, you know, tan 30 is equal to AB divided by DB means what? DB means DC plus CB. DC plus CB. That is BC is same as what? CB, no. So this we can write it as root 3 CB. Both are same. So CB both are same. AB we can replace it as root 3 CB. Or we have what? 1 by root 3 is equal to AB divided by DC plus CB. Let it be the. Next, we have to equate that. So So let it be equation number 1 and this will be equation number 2. How can we equate this 2? Can we equate this directly? Here we have what? AB is equal to root 3 CB, no? So here in first equation we have what? AB is equal to root 3 BC. That is equation number 1. So same AB if we take means then we can equate. So instead of writing this equation number 2, instead of this as equation number 2, we can cross multiply this. So root 3 AB is equal to what? DC plus CB. No? So AB will be what? AB is equal to DC plus CB divided by root 3, isn't it? So here first equation also in form of AB is equal to, here also AB is equal to. So then it is easy for you to equate. So this you mark it as equation number B. So equating left side, both are AB. So we can equate the right side. That means BC is same as what? CB. So BC means what? CB. Starting itself you write BC instead of BC, you write it as CB. That is enough. So no problem. No? CB. So CB. So equating, next step is what? Equating equation number 1 and equation number 2. What is that? Root 3 CB. CB is equal to what? DC plus CB divided by root 3. Okay. What about DC? DC is given as 40. So root 3 CB plus DC we can substitute. Sorry, not plus, equal. Is equal to 40 plus CB divided by root 3. This can be written as root 3 CB by 1. Cross multiply. Root 3 CB into root 3 is what? Root 3 into 3? 3. CB is equal to 40 plus CB into 1 is what? 40 plus CB. Okay. So we can take the CB to the left side. So 3 CB minus CB is equal to 40. 3 CB minus CB is what? CB means 1 CB. So 2 CB is equal to 40. That means CB is equal to 40 by 2. CB is equal to 20. That is what? CB is the width of the river. CB is the width of the river. Therefore, width of the river is equal to 20 meters. All are in meters, so we can write it as 20 meters. From the first equation, we have what? B's C and AB we have one connection, that is AB is equal to what? Root 3 BC. What is? Or BC, or we can write it as CB. Okay. Root 3 CB. AB is what? AB is the height of the tree. We have to find out the height of the tree, no? So how can we write? AB is known as the height of the tree. So, AB is equal to what? Root 3. We can substitute CB as 20. So, 20 root 3. So, 20 into 1.732. Root 3 value 1.732 into 20. That is AB. So, AB we will get it as 34.64 meter. That is the height of the tree. That is the height of the tree is equal to 34.64 meters. Okay. Thank you.